You can have varieties of girls and varieties of food. Exactly the same. If you try to avoid one and then stick to the other, you are not going to succeed. Everything is a pleasure moment. Don't condemn.
If we avoid both?
Not a question of avoiding. You are trying to rise above them or say have one without the other. That is not it. Both go. So you are not caught up between the good and bad and the right and the wrong.
When do both go, sir?
When you go.
Come on, we'll go.
You are finished. That is all that is there. Nothing else is there. Don't believe all that nonsense, that there is a self, that there is a soul, that there is an I. Nothing. If you look at it and say that it is a carpet, that is you. Nothing else is there. What is so marvelous about it? So if you don't do that, you are coming to an end. You have to keep doing that. Every time you look at it, you have a carpet that is red, this is a white, and that's a man, that's a woman. Or I am happy, or I am unhappy, I am miserable, I am greedy, I am jealous. You see, you have a beautiful girl. Or a wife. If somebody makes passes at your wife, you should be proud.
That is very artificial.
That, no, that is not artificial. To say that you are jealous is wrong.
But
jealousy doesn't exist.
There is no other way other than being jealous.
No, that is what they put like that anywhere. On this planet,
whatever is here is extraordinary.
Yes.
Unique, unparalleled. How do you know that?
I know that, you see, it will express itself. But then you don't go around the world telling people, I am unique, there is nobody like me, I am the one and the only one. No, not at all. You are calling me unique. I will never tell myself that I am a unique being. I can tell you, but you will not come to me and thank me. My encounter with you has helped me to come into my own, to become me, no. Nor will I be fooled by what you are saying. That's the end of it. You will not go anywhere and ask anybody. That's the only acid test. What brings you here, it will take you somewhere else. If you go away and find some real guru, I will not be hurt. I'll be happy he's gone. I'm telling you, I mean it. I will not be hurt if you go away and find some other people. There are so many people promising you so many things. Why the hell do you come here? Waste your time. What do you want, sir? What do you want? Any moment there, what do you want? You are now beginning to think, what do I want?
If that question is transferred to you, something, what do you want of this? What will you answer?
No moment here, no answer. Even if I say no answer, that's an answer. You see, this is not listening. The listening mechanism is just recording your question here. The translator has to come. The translator is not there. The translator is the one who translates that and tries to find if there is any answer to the question. You see, it is listening to so many things. I never listen to anybody. Yuji, if he is there, he tries to understand what you are asking. You see, you don't know, I was telling you, see, this morning, you remember? They don't need the help. This body is an extraordinarily intelligent body. Its survival is all that it matters. Not your idea of the survival of the body. If the noise out there is above certain decibel level, which it cannot take, it cuts off. It doesn't hear anything I'm telling you. All this nonsense you are talking, the nervous system will be damaged. Don't believe all that shit. It cuts out and then it moves away. It doesn't sit there to tell itself that I can sit here without listening to that. That's not it. Like you see, you look at the bright sun, automatically your eyes shut. Otherwise you will be damaged. The tears are not there. You see, it's an expression of your emotions, kindness, this, that, the other. You see, these emotions are now, you see, bad for that body. It doesn't want any of your emotions. The tears are there only to lubricate your eyes, otherwise you will go blind. You can test blind. It is protecting itself. That is why the tears are there. Don't translate them as tears of joy. Nothing. You will never cry in your life. Once the old man asked me, have you ever cried in your life, sir? Never in my life. Probably the baby in arms. I don't remember. Now I want to cry for you. Go ahead. He did cry somewhere, sometime. For me, poor fellow. Old chap, old chap, old chap. When he heard that I was in bad straits, cry to your heart's content. It doesn't touch me. Any of these people who come and talk to me, I don't even have handkerchiefs to give. It is not going to touch me. The heart is not there to be kind, to be nice, to be affectionate, to be this, that and the other. If you do that, you will have a cardiac arrest. It is just there only to pump blood. No other purpose. Sorry.
Which is more dangerous among positive and negative emotions?
But there is no such thing as positive and negative. You are dividing them into positive and negative. All emotions are the same. And the body rejects them. It is not. It is more intelligent than you credit that body with, I'm telling you. The intelligence that is there, you can't even imagine. And they don't need all these bastards who tell what is good for their body. I'm telling you. It doesn't want anything you think is good for the body. Much less the spiritual rubbish. It is not interested. It is rejecting. That is why there is misery in you. The misery is there because of that. It doesn't want anything, any feelings.
Misery means physical misery or psychological misery?
No, psychological. Physical misery, it can take care of it. Psychological memory, don't. Fresh air is a psychological need. I don't want to use that filthy word psychological. There is no psyche, and so there is no question of psychological thing. I have to put it that way. It is a sensual thing when you go out and say, how? Why do you have to say that? I sleep in a small dog's kennel. I don't even have windows in my room. You are telling me that fresh air is necessary? Don't tell me all that nonsense. If physical exercise is necessary, you will die, that fellow, you know. Jogging, that bastard died in the tracks and he made a lot of money by publishing. I was so surprised, so many young girls. It is not an experience.
How do you know that all these things? You explain.
I know that.
You know that.
Yes. I have been putting it in your filthy language to communicate to you.
But it's not experienced here.
No,
you can't believe here.
It's not an experience. How can you experience? I'm telling you.
So either
I have to use the common experience, some common language, to tell you, don't try it. Everything I say, you are trying to experience within the framework of your experiencing structure. That's all that it is interested in. You want to know more and more and more. You already know a lot. You don't need to know anything more. Or from anybody, for that matter. Much less from me. Don't listen to all that crap, you see. The art of seeing, the art of knowing, the art of listening. Freedom from the known. And yet you describe that state as love, bliss, beatitude, immensity. It's a self speech, sir.
As you said, there's a uniqueness.
That uniqueness will never be experienced by you or by anybody. That's what I'm saying.
But when you say each is unique, it expresses something.
No, you will not talk all that rubbish.
If I am talking, I myself unique, sir.
You are not unique.
You are unique, sir.
Not what you are saying.
I mean,
what you are not saying. You use any other word. You don't go around telling that I'm a very unique being. No. So I use that word to point out that you are trying to copy something, imitate something, and become some other chappy. That is our culture. We always wanted to be like Buddha, like this fellow, like that. And that Buddha was the filthiest bastard that the world has ever seen or will ever see. How do I find out? How can I be so certain of that? The certainty I have can never be transferred to you, cannot be transmitted to you. no power in the world can convince me that he was a great teacher, the greatest teacher. No power in the world. This certainty, this is not a logically accepted premise. This certainty that all the teachers, it doesn't mean that I am far superior to them. I am the top one, I am a combination and confusion of so many things.
If this is not logical, then what else is it, sir?
You cannot, but logic is collapsing there. Why do you use logic? Tell me. First statement, I brushed aside as a student of logic there in my university. Annambattas, Tarkasangara, Ayatra, Tatra, Atra, Dhoma, Ayatra, Ayatra. What rubbish you are talking? Why do you link up? Why do you tell me that the smoke is the cause of this fire? I am not ready to accept. For 3 months, those bastards give lectures on that. I am telling you as a student of philosophy, Indian logic is no match to the Western logic. No match. I studied both Eastern and Western logic as a student. Extraordinarily intelligent people. These are all filthy bastards, Indian logicians. Nothing, I'm telling you. Because they freed themselves from the religious stranglehold.
Western logicians.
Western logicians. Western philosophy. Here you went on and on and on. You could not break away from the religious thinking. So that is why you see Western logic in many respects far superior to that of Indian logic. Anybody who has studied both will tell you. Although I didn't care for the Bosang case, logic or some silly nonsense, all of them rubbish. You know, but even they didn't have the guts. Even Kant said that there is no way you can experience the reality of anything. He said, it was an intellectual concept he arrived at. There, that's all. Even the scientists, you swallow them bastards when they say, there is no way you can experience the reality of anything. You are projecting your ideations and mentations on what you are looking at. I know I have seen so many of these fellows. They can't fool me. You can touch this. It never says that. The sense of touch never tells you that this is hard. Never. So when do you feel that this is hard? When the thought enters into the thought is memory. Thought, memory, consciousness, all memory. Memory is noise, sound, nothing else is there. Even if you talk to your silently, your vocal cords are involved. Don't believe all that nonsense that they are telling, nuances, and all that rubbish. There is nothing there. Brain plays a very, very minor role in that living organism. Very minor role. I know I have seen a lot of brain physiologists and psychologists. I know lots of them. They have no chance with me. You can go and teach this nonsense. Never will you tell yourself that this is hard. So when does this space come into? Only when you say that this is hard, then it becomes hard. So, that is the reason why they define the thought, you see, you know, that which gives materiality and substance to this. Thought is matter. So, it cannot stay there long. The body depends upon the sensory perceptions, nothing else. My grandmother taught me that sky is blue. So, why that hell do you have to tell yourself? Every time you look at that sky is blue, I want to know. It is that is necessary for you. Every time you look at the tree, you have to tell yourself there's a coconut tree. If you don't do it, you are preoccupied with something else. The physical sensory activity is occupied with whatever is happening here at this moment. Don't listen to all that crap. Moment, living from moment to moment. This is the moment. What you have to say is more important than all of them put together. You tell me something about the present moment. Now, tell me something about it. Whatever is going on in the past, whatever movement is there in the past, so you will never, never know anything about the present. And so many people, I was in a thoughtless state, wonderful, but who is it that says that you are in a thoughtless state, and why the hell you are describing thoughtless state to me? Thought was very much there, but otherwise you can't experience a thoughtless state. It's a sales speech, marketing. Good, there are enough fools. You can't put yourselves. Don't for a moment imagine that this is void and empty in my case. It is fully occupied with whatever is happening at this moment. Where, as in your case, you are preoccupied with something totally unrelated. That's why you see, you can't see, you have never in your life seen anything, probably as a baby now.
How to prevent that preoccupation?
Why do you want to prevent? How? Because I am saying.
Because it's causing inefficiency in my profession. Something
no,
like that.
No, no, no. You are told that you must be very attentive, that you must concentrate, focus on that thing. There is no such thing as concentration as far as the functioning of the body is concerned. Distraction. All the time. Distracted by everything that is happening. Now, I am distracted by the reflection of light on her glasses. That's the most important thing in that frame. Nothing else can come in.
But physical distraction is something acceptable. There is mental distraction.
No, there is no such thing as physical distraction.
Why am I not functioning that way then?
You are functioning that way. They are telling you that you should function in a different way. That's all. The body is functioning in exactly the same way.
Why are you not recognizing that as you recognize it?
No, you don't want to do it because that will be the end of you. What will happen to your wife, your children? You are looking at your wife, you don't know that you are looking at your wife. That's the end of it. You will not go and pick up another chick, what they said. How do you listen to that sound if you are not listening? You tell me. Bob, you see, without calling Bob, you tell yourself, produce the same sound inside of you. Nothing. Don't repeat all that nonsense.
That is the,
they don't know what they are talking about. You will find out. You will be surprised all that is nonsense, what they are teaching you.
Till I brush everything aside, I can't.
No, no question of brushing aside. Brushing aside, you can only replace that with another nonsense. You can't really brush anything outside. You have to replace it with something else.
What do you mean
why,
by really?
Why do they all have their names? Sushma, this name, other name. Huh?
What do you really mean by brushing aside, sir?
There is no way you can brush anything aside. You have to replace it with something else. You call it brushing aside. Without replacing, there is no brushing aside.
But you are not replaced anything, sir.
What do you mean?
How did you brush
it? I haven't brushed anything aside. What are you talking about? You assume, presume that I have brushed aside everything. No.
You told that people.
It cannot influence my actions.
You told it you have brushed it aside.
So that is a way of putting things, you see. You have to brush it aside means it, I know that you cannot brush it aside. What is there is all that is there. It was there. It's no, you can't draw a line and say the way he described me, before and after. Before and after is only the surf. Wash. Before wash and after wash.
Well, that's what happened.
But they have experienced something.
They can experience, as he himself admitted, it's subjective.
No.
No. There is no such thing as objectivity at all. Everything is subjective. Even in my case, it is subjective. When UG is there, all his prejudices, personal likes, dislikes, predilections, everything is there. No such thing as an unconditioned mind. Conditioning will not go, but conditioning cannot influence your actions. Any action you see is a conditioned action. There is no action at all. The actions are all reactions. All your actions. All your likes, dislikes, everything reactions.
In your case?
Even if I am reacting like anybody else. All my likes, dislikes, prejudices, personal things, they are all there. They cannot.
They are all reactions.
No action is there.
That is the only action, whether I am acting or you are acting or anybody is acting. It's a reaction. There is no action at all. Not spontaneous, pure action. All that is absolute rubbish.
Action never exists.
Never, doesn't exist.
In anyone's case.
In
anybody.
That's all. They can claim all those things. Pure action, spontaneous action. You see, it cannot be separated, you see. Stimulus and response is one unitary movement. It is not that nonsense they talk, oneness of life, unity of life. You cannot be separated from what you are looking at. You see, unless you know what you are looking at, you cannot say that that is a tree. The physical eye does not see that as a round tree. It is flat because it is focused on only one side. If you say that the tree is round, it is born out of your imagination here, not the tree is round. You can take me there, take me round and show that it is round. All that is useless. The physical eye, I am sitting here, it sees the tree as flat. Everything, all that is like, you see the painting there. There is no depth there, no matter who says what. The physical eye, I am talking about the physical eye, you know, can not see the depth at all. You see, you are sitting in front, all those, you see the frame. It doesn't see, it's all one, you see the trees there in the back. It is very close, you cannot say that that is far away from the window.
What about the concept of distance, sir?
It's all, distance is only measurement.
If you can't see the depth, how can you walk safely, sir?
You'll fall. When you go there, no, you will not fall. The body is more intelligent. It knows how to protect itself. There, you see, you move away from the wall. Not sit here and say that the wall is there, you are going to hit your head.
No, that's what we do.
Nothing is there. Only when you are there, automatically you turn.
You are going to descend.
Like a water flowing, there is a rock, either it flows over or sideways. That is how all your actions are. You don't think before sitting.
Never plan anything.
No. I have to plan certain things.
Even that.
Fourth, I am going to Madras, we are saying 17th Tuesday. There is no guarantee. I may drop dead. Something can happen in between. Where is the guarantee?
Then why was the
law of averages? Why you give importance to them? Sorry?
Why was the depth perception, third dimension brought into?
We are all taught. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Why, sir?
The fear. The mother teaches everything, you see. Don't go there.
Yes, how does it come about?
Because this mechanism that is translating it all the time, selectivity is there, censorship is there. And so it is not recording, you see. You don't, you see, recording is taking place without all that. You see, that you are the problem, not the tape recorder is recording everything. You see, regardless of your ideas of selectivity, and so these are two different things. This listening mechanism is not listening to anything. See, listening means translation. The translator is there all the time. Somehow this fellow comes and goes. You see, it doesn't mean that I don't know. You see, when you walk in, you see, I recognize you. The moment I recognize you, I can say that you are whatever you are. And then it is gone. See. So, it's not why do I have to tell myself, you are also functioning in exactly the same way. All of us, all the human bodies are functioning in exactly the same way.
Why do you say thought is only sound? Why not light, sir?
The sound and light are interchangeable, sir.
It's okay. Yes, say that it's audio visual. Why only audio?
I'm not saying that. If you want to create an image out of those words,
yes,
you see, like you can go into a laboratory today and put this to test, you see, they are interchangeable. That is why you have images of all these gods, goddesses, godlets walking hand in hand with you.
First time somebody has used the word godlet.
I don't think they have read any letter. It's a starlet.
It's a starlet. Little kids, you see.
Starlet.
Part of the gods and goddesses, I call them godlings. Gods and goddesses. God. You see, you already have an image of that. You create an image. So that is all right. If you, that's what I am saying. Your wife, your daughter is sitting there. You may be looking at this. I may be looking at my daughter. Never do I tell myself that that is my daughter. If you ask me, who is she? That is my daughter. Cut again. So the situation is the same again. So we had this problem with Valentine. Immediately after this, I was looking at the cow. My situation is exactly the same. But at that time, in the beginning, it was a problem for me. So what is that Valentine, that cow? And after another second, what is that Valentine cow? She was so disgusted with this. That is cow. How many times do I have to say? It went on and on and on and on. Now I don't ask anybody because this has gotten into that rhythm of life. So even if I ask myself, who is he? Yes, the answer comes.
Did you relearn everything? Did you relearn everything?
No, not necessary.
Are you?
No, there is no need to relearn anything because all that is there,
the here,
in whatever you want to call it, is
well,
computer, memory. So, I quoted yesterday something that I memorized 65 years ago, but it is there. You know, in a given situation, it comes out. So, because you are adding more and more and more knowledge, it is going down. Basically, it is always there. When once it is recorded, like the message there, 100 years it will live, even if you cut off. Probably there is some way you can reactivate a dead body back to life. All that will come back. I don't know. I can't say any definitive statements about that. See, I'm not competent enough. Maybe that possibility is there. You see, what you call life is like the electricity, you know. That is the energy. Life's energy, that is all that is there. You will never experience life at all. The living thing cannot be experienced by the experiencing structure. See, what happened in my case, accidentally I stepped on the live wire. That's all. Then it burns. Live wire. It burns the whole thing. Everything that is there is a living thing. Your jealousy, I was talking about your jealousy. You will never know what jealousy is, I'm telling you. See, you are dealing with how to be free from jealousy and not jealousy. Because you have been fooled by people that you should not be jealous, that you should be free from jealous. I'm telling you, if you have a beautiful wife, if people want to snatch her away from you or make passes at her, you must be proud that you have a beautiful wife. Everybody is making passes at your beautiful wife and then they want to snatch her away. You must be proud. But why do you say that you are jealous? It is not jealousy.
But here comes the fear of losing, sir.
It is possessiveness. You think you possess that choice of money, knowledge, but not a living thing. You can never possess a living person. No. Discards. Whatever life is left there, it lives. And then goes gracefully. And it will be recycled. The usefulness of the body is there is only for recycling. No other purpose.
What is the reason for this imperfection, sir?
Huh?
What is the reason for this imperfection?
Slowly, I think, I don't know.
The glands
I can't
are
say.
Functional. Yeah? UM is fulfilling. The glands are not
inactive. That is why it is not. It has come into its own completely and totally.
Why?
No, why? That is an idiotic question. Only an idiot asks the question.
Why?
I have read all the books on medical.
No, it is improperly functioning, all the glands, inactive.
Yes, it takes time, nature takes time, probably. I don't know whether there is any such thing as perfection. It is not that spiritual perfection, that doesn't exist, only this one.
Physical.
So then if you make a statement like that, you have to accept that there is such a thing as evolution. I don't accept that at all. There may not be any such thing as all the bastard wrote Darwin's the original species, it is outdated, outmoded, and passe, that nonsense. You know? Even then, you see, listen to me, you see. I don't want to use these scientific terms because they are very misleading as far as I am concerned. So, there is probably we are all the products of the degenerate species, monkeys. Three they have. The one we have today is the same thing, the middle one disappeared. And probably some sort of a mutation occurred, and the human species is the result of that. So degenerate species. And then what I am saying is that you cannot relate it to that. You see, the mutation occurs, and when once it occurs, what is here now cannot be related to anything that was there before. You understand? That is why you are wanting to know how I was like before has no meaning. So these two things cannot be compared. There is no way you can relate what is there now with what was there before. So you can say that he looked like that, he acted like that. So that is applicable only to the surf washing soap. You wash it before wash and after wash. A good commercial to sell their products.
So perfection of this organism is not my responsibility, it is nature's responsibility.
Yeah, but you remain perfect. Where do you want to activate? You will get cancer. That friend of mine, Prasad, death doesn't exist, sir. This body does not know that it is alive at this moment. You see, what actually death is, we will never know. You can define death, bring your doctor, examine me, and say that this is dead, dead purpose. But still, the living organism is functioning in its own way, and so many other forms of life will come out of this. One form of life lives on another form of life. Even that you are destroying, you see. We will pay a very, very heavy price for that. Not that some other force is going to destroy you. You are making it, you see, so difficult to survive on this planet. Sorry?
Yuji,
yeah.
This is on the way to perfection you told, and there is...
No, I withdraw.
And at the same time, you told another one that it's already perfect.
I don't know, you see. What? Then you want me to define perfection.
No.
They are, for some reason, they have remained inactive. Why they are activated suddenly, I don't know. I don't have any answer. Then you can say it is functioning in a perfect way. Not any idea of your spiritual perfection. That doesn't exist. I'm talking about this only.
So that is nature's responsibility, not our responsibility.
Nature has no responsibility for you. What do you mean, nature is...
Perfection. Perfecting this.
Perfection is this not the goal. See, I'm sorry, I have to drop that word. You can't think of perfection. See, not that something is trying to perfect it. It is imperfect means that it's not something else is perfecting it. Sorry, it's not in that sense.
It is perfecting itself.
It is for some reason, it is not... they are not activated, functioning.
So what is that reason?
All the superimposition of that nonsense you are talking about, karna chakra, this chakra, that chakra, that is responsible.
Oh, that is responsible.
Yeah. Instead of that, naturally.
Yeah, otherwise it's already perfect.
Yeah, you drop the word perfect. Perfection is a definition.
Only cultural input is preventing the activation.
Activation, you see. You know, the harm that it is. You see, you don't tell me or don't tell yourself that the body is not in a position to deal with it. It is rejecting everything. Everything you think is good for that body.
Is it rejecting you? Is it rejecting UG also?
The UG has to go first.
Is it rejecting
you? He cannot stay here anymore. That is the problem. He comes and goes, and he is not important anymore. Why do I have to tell myself that you are this, that and the other, that you are not this, that and the other? What for? Keep that knowledge going all the time. There's no use, no value. It's not necessary. Except when it is necessary, it comes up just like that. See, nothing stands in the way. There is no searching there. If it is not there, it is not there. It doesn't tell itself or others that it is not there. If it is there, it comes up. And it is you that is playing with this.
Very easy. Nataraj, the moon on the Mars.
Yes.
What the hell are they doing? Do other and better things than to bother about this guy, right? Enough, sir. Thank you very much. Nice seeing you.